Everybody, it's Danny here at Total Geek Live, and I'm super excited because this is an unboxing video. Don't get to do a lot of those, and I've been wanting to, and luckily I stumbled upon a few treasures in the clearance section at Walmart recently, and I saved over $100, and I'm very, very excited about this. First up is the unboxing of this. Yes, it's a Transformers G1 reissue or whatever, Generation 1 of Hot Rod. Normally, it was supposed to retail at $29.84. I'm sorry if any of you out there paid full price, because I got it for $7 plus tax. That's right, $7 plus tax. And I'm super excited about it. So let's just go ahead and get this thing unboxed, because I've had it for a few weeks now, well, probably actually more than a month, and I've been wanting to open it. So it's pretty cool. You can see the cover, or the front of it, is very, very old school, and just like, you know, back in the 80s. And then on the back, they even include the what his function is, and here's like the strength, price, his intelligence, speed, endurance, and so it's kind of a rating system. And I think I remember, like, at one point in time there was some kind of red goggles that you looked at in order to see this clearly, but I don't have those right now. But that's really cool. So you see Metroplex City right there, and a bunch of the different Decepticons and Transformers battling it out. So I'm very, very, very excited about this. I've got my scissors ready. So there's just two pieces of tape, one on each side here. So let's go ahead and delicately open this up and see what what we have in here. Old Hot Rod. I never got to own a Hot Rod when I was a kid, so this is really exciting. I loved him in the Transformers movie, and just loved his style and character and all of that. Oops. Alright, so we'll put the box aside over here, and then see, okay, so there are some sticker decals. Pretty shiny, metallic. Let's get them out of the package and get a better look. Just one set. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 stickers total. Okay. And then there's this awesome piece of paper to tell us how to transform him. Oh, and he's got the mounted guns on the front. Check that out. Oh, there's a lot going on here. All right, so let's get him out of the box. So everything's still nice and neat. There are these little rubber band things holding things in place. Here's his two guns. So go ahead and get those out. Yes, 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 yes. Always have to equip this part. There we go. Just slide the guns out. So I kind of want to keep everything as intact as possible for this. But looks like with these rubber bands, get Hot Rod out, I may not be able to achieve that. No, it looks like you're gonna have to cut them. The guns were easy, but maybe, hold on, might have some luck here. We'll just kind of pull this off here. Just slide it down front of his, yeah, so see, there you go. So got the first one off right there. I'm hoping I could just kind of, yep, pop it right out, and so I got to keep things intact in case I want to slide it back in there later. So he's pretty groovy, a lot heavier than what I expected. We're looking at all the different features of him. I like the already added stickers on here that I would have not done a very good job of putting the flames on. It looks like they did a better one. And then there's the Autobot symbol. So let's see if they, from what I remember, like when I was a kid, you had your heat kind of activated it. Yeah, so see, you can kind of shows up red as you put heat on it. Otherwise, it just kind of goes back to dark. I think that's true. So let's see all the different things he's got here. Busting out. Okay, so this is where his head is. Alright. And then, because I see his feet down here. Ooh, popping those out. So trying to, I don't want to look at the instructions. I want to kind of try and figure it out myself. Yep, arms coming out here. And I'm guessing like this slides up or something. Let's see what his head's gonna do. Because his head's gotta rotate. There we go. Yep, nice flip over there. Alright. But this part on the back here, trying to figure out like how does that quite work. Oh, and this turns around. Okay, so you gotta flip this. So that flips like that. And then how does this part? Oh, okay, it twists. So, twist it like that, boom. And it's up. And then, so then you just lower his chest piece into there. I'm trying to see if everything will get locked into place. Okay, there, yep, snap. And then, looks like his chest piece snaps into that part right there. So to speak, kind of snaps, not really. Ooh, crap. Okay, there. Okay, there. You just kind of work with it. See, I don't remember them being this complicated, but of course it was. I think it was different. Like when I was a kid, it was die-cast metal instead. Okay, so there's an interesting thing. His arms kind of mess with the chest area. So things don't really lock into place there. Kind of have to be careful with how he places his arms. Unless I'm missing something. See, let's see. Now they've got him going straight on. Straight on like that. It's almost like they need to pop out a little bit more. I don't know. And then you're supposed to put the guns there in his hands. But I don't know, look at this. So you see right here, there's his arms bump up against this part right here. So there's only so much you can do to bring it in tight and keep this part locked in and stuff. Whereas on the instructions kind of looks like there on number six. It makes it look like you could actually make them almost, 45 degree angles or 90 degree angles, whatever, like straight on, not where he's like out here side to side, but like fully straight on there. Oh, and then here's the places where once you have them in robot form, then there's a diagram to tell you where to put the stickers on. I'm not going to do that for this video, because stickers take a long time and I want to get it right. I'm not even sure if I want to put them on, but he's pretty cool looking. So he's like, like 3.5, 4 inches tall, in robot form, and he's got pretty good movement there with his arms. He can only point down. So you see there, can't really move that much there, up to there. So that's about all the arm movement you get with him. As he can shoot like this, like pew 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 pew, and not really up. You're not gonna get a lot of up arm movement with him there, and then the down movement. So he's pretty much gonna jump up in the air and John Wick 'em from down below. Pew, 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 pew. While they're down below, he's up in the air. Yep. So that's pretty cool. So let's try and get him back into car form so I can take one of the guns and put it on the front like they have in the very, very first diagram there. So let's try that. All right, so I remember something about these guys coming up here and this twisting back into place this way. Okay, so that's that, and then his head kind of tucks in, but you want to make sure, because you got to get the motor, so you got to make sure that the head unclicks so you can flip it, because part of the engine that comes out on the top of the hood is there, and then you can see he's peeking in there. All right, and then the arms fold back in into place like that. And then his legs, he's got his little feet, so you flip them back like so. Boop, boop. Let's make a little bit better than that. There we go. Feet, and then pretty much just slide these back in like that. And there you go. He's back to being a hot rod. Pretty easy transformation. And then you just put one of the guns in the top of the engine like that, and he's all set. You've got to just find a place to put this where it's not gonna get lost. It'll go with the stickers. But that's it. That's pretty cool. A little hot rod G1 Transformer remake reissue, whatever you want to call it. I like it's funny. It says Autobot Cavalier Hot Rod on there. So that's the little description here. Right there. So pretty cool. I'm definitely hyped that I got it for $7. I definitely think that, if that's in your budget, and you can go out. I found it at Walmart. It seems to be the only place that's selling these right now. So definitely, if you're a Transformers fan and a toy enthusiast, whatever, collector or whatever, and you see these out there, and you're like, you know what? I've got $7 to spend. Then I definitely think that this would definitely should be a consideration for you. It's pretty solid for that kind of money. Would I pay the full price of the $29.84 plus tax? I don't think so. I think really when you get into talking about $30 or more for a toy of this size, then I'm gonna expect it be made out of die-cast metal and not plastic. Yeah. So, but I'm pretty happy for getting it for the price point I did, and I can't wait to add it to the collection and all of that. So that's it, guys, for this video. That was an unboxing with the Hot Rod G1 reissue, whatever, that Walmart's got going out. And I'll be doing other videos, unboxing videos. I've got Starscream that I picked up and Devastator, which I'm so excited about because I never, ever, ever, ever had the chance of having Devastator or any of the other multiple combining, the combiners, Transformers when I was a kid. So to finally pick one up and kind of play with it, it's like a dream come true for me. And, of course, reliving a little childhood here, but it's all in fun. And so got those coming up, and hopefully later on. I know right now in the stores there's the Optimus Prime, but it doesn't come with a trailer right now, and that price point's at like $50 retail. So I'm really gonna keep an eye on that to see when it goes down in price and eventually hits the clearance section. And then I'm also hearing rumors that a Soundwave reissue will be coming out either this month or next month, but it's supposed to follow right along with the Optimus Prime, so I'll definitely check that out. But again, I'm a budget guy. I like to save money, so I'll probably wait until I can find it on sale. But hopefully I can get those so that I can make more videos of unboxing them and show you guys all the cool features and all that, and hopefully it'll give a good decision, help you make the decision of purchasing one for yourself. So definitely be on the lookout for those videos. And that's it for now, guys. But thanks for tuning in, watching this video, and I'm very excited about doing a whole lot more unboxing videos as the year progresses. 2019, expect a lot more unboxing stuff from me and hopefully the other guys here at Total Geek Live. So all I got left to say is it's all geek to us. Bye, guys.
If you're gonna ride, Dano, ride in style!